Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Beakey and welcome back to the Neo Nails channel. We're getting ready because I've got some of our juicy nails too. The nail beds are insane. Oh my God. Honest to God, they're just so long and so beautiful and the cuticles are so amazing. It's amazing. I'll show you. Oh, look at Charlotte's nails. Just look at them. However, these are the kind of nails that you get in a salon every day. So this is going to be a good video. We're going to do Charlotte's nails. So we're going to do acrylic design, little bit of foiling. We're going to show you. Look, we've done one hand already. This is what we're going to do. If you want to know how to do it, keep watching. So, before we start, we're going to use the hand sanitizer, alcohol gel. So I'm going to prep Charlotte's nails with an electric file, and you can see that Charlotte has the most bitten nails. Well, she's got bitten nails and she's got quite a lot of cuticle. So I'm going to use the electric file to remove any non-living tissue and also push back the cuticles. If you don't have an electric file, you can push them back with the cuticle pusher. That is absolutely fine. I just prefer to use a electric file because I can really get in there. So I'm going to do this on all the nails. Now Charlotte will have some sore patches and things like that, so I need to be conscious of that and obviously be as gentle as I can in those areas. I'm going to go over with a fine grit sanding band. You could use a 240 grit file, like this one, which will be nice and soft. But because Charlotte's nails are quite deep at the sides as well, I feel like using a sanding band is easier. I can really get into those sides. So I'm going to wipe over the nails with the gel residue wipe off solution, and we're going to use tips today. So these need to be super clean, because when you're applying tips, you do need the nail to be super dry, nice and dehydrated, as it will affect the adhesion of the tip. So you can see how dehydrated they go nice and chalky. And we're going to have a little bit of glue. And I like to put it on, swipe back, and then rest the tip on. Hold it for a few seconds. Then use my little tweezers. Hold down the corners. So if you've got quite a flat nail or a nail that doesn't match the shape of the tip, then if you use the little tweezers, it'll hold down the corners so it'll contour to the shape of the natural nail. So let's do that on all of these nails. Right, so I'm going to size these up now. So I've got my tip cutters. So I'm just going to take them to there first, and then I'm going to look at them here, check from cuticle to tip. So can you see how this one is a little bit longer? I am just going to file that a little bit just to reduce that down, plus they will get filed, so you need to allow about a millimeter of filing room. because when you come to file the nails into shape, they will go a little bit shorter. If I did these tips exactly the same length as they are now, because these are pre-done, I've done them already, they've already been filed. If I did that, then this set would end up shorter. That makes sense? Right, so I'm going to use a 240 grit file just to blend in the tip and shape the tip. So you want to make sure your side walls are nice and straight. I'm giving these tips a little bit of a pinch just to make them more of a tapered square slash ballerina. Right, so I'm going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution. Right, so I'm going to dehydrate and then we're going to prime. We're going to use the Ultra Bond Acid Primer. Now Charlotte's got horsies, so we need to make sure these do not lift or anything. Right, so we're going to use Caramel Dream, not used Caramel Dream in so long. Ideally, you want to use this in one bead when you're doing a reverse smile line, because if you don't, if you start adding extra beads on, you do see the line between each bead. So I'm going to pop the bead on and create my smile line. So we've got a nice brick wall. You can do the same on the pinky. Now this is a tiny pinky, you have the most tiniest hands. So you want it nice and thin at the cuticle area, but at this smile line area, you want to be able to have this brick wall. You'll notice as the product starts to set, you can really get this smile line into a nice shape and it'll hold shape. Caramel Dream does set up really quickly. I'm using medium liquid. Right, so for colours, we've got tribal accent, we've got amber lights, glam gold, meringue. So they're the colours we're going to use. But for these two we've just done, we're going to use... Oh, there's another colour, isn't there? There is another colour. Where's that beige colour? I knew there was another colour. That one is Tuscan Earth. So for these two that we've just done, this smile line, we're going to use the tribal accent. So I'm walking the product up the sides into those corners. Now I'm going to use a bead of True Pink, which is transparent. It will add a little bit of a pink hue to the Caramel Beige, Caramel Dream, sorry. And it will also be great to cap the tribal accent colour in. And it will not change the colour of the tribal accent because it's not of the same colour palette. And it's very thin. Same on the pinky, on the stinky pinky. Walk it up the sides. Right, so this one, which is, what colour is this? Tuscan Earth. I'm going to pop this here And I'm gonna blend it back. And then I'm gonna blend it a little bit thinner on the tip. So we're kind of using this for more color than anything. So not really strength. It will give strength, but this is more for color. And then here at this very tip, I'm gonna put this color. So that Tuscan Earth. Like that, blend it up. So everything's very neutral toned. Meringue, right, we're gonna get a bit of meringue. Not actual meringue, that would be a bit weird, wouldn't it?
I love this one.
Oh, it's so nice. It's got like loads of different glitters in it. It's got the like little fuzzies, which are like little lines. Flitters, I think they call them. And it's also got the chunky glitter as well. And it's got like an iridescent glitter as well running through it. So it's very nice. And then we're going to take a little bit of amber lights. Because we're kind of blending this down, so small amount of amber lights. And we're going to go directly over the top just to add a little bit more gold, and then we can bring that down a little bit just to add a little bit of shimmer. And again, I'm using True Pink to cap. Now for this one, we're going to use multiple colors. We're going to wait fast. Give that a bit of a marble. Just gonna move that around into spaces that I want it. Adding that little bit of gold. So when I was doing the marble, I made sure I put a little bit of this True Pink down because it's transparent and it really does help the marble move nicely. And I'm going to cap a little bit of this now. I did layer it a bit because I'll file through some little bits just to give a bit of depth. Right, thumb, same again. Obviously, we're gonna do it a little bit different. We don't want it all the same. But we're gonna use the same colors. And I'm putting a little bit of that True Pink in there as well. Let's see how many we can get in this. Working pretty quick. Swirl through. I'm just going to use the tip of the brush just to etch in here because I want to feed in a little bit of that Arabian Lights, and then we're going to cap with True Pink. Just going to put a pinching tool on the middle and turn the hand to the side, and you need to make sure that doesn't come off. Is that okay there? Yep. Pinching tool on. Right, I am going to use an electric file around the cuticle area, just because the nail tucks in so much into the skin, it'll be a little bit easier to use an electric file than a nail file. Right, so I'm going to electric file over the top, removing any bulk. Just get them nice and smooth. Right, so now we've gone over with the electric file, we're going to go in the hand file and tweak the shape, get the sidewalls nice and straight. I love this colour combination because it will go with so many things.
So are you going for the alternative Christmas look?
Yeah, I didn't really want red or silvers or, you know, anything too Christmassy. I wanted something that's going to last me and that will go with anything I wear. And I quite like the neutral colours at the moment. I'm feeling the neutral vibe.
I am clearly. I'm clearly after the neutral vibe. What do you think, Adam?
Sorry?
Luke, I'm on the neutral vibe, Luke.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Very neutral.
Yeah.
You blend in.
So those of you that like sort of housey, inspirational Instagrams, Charlotte's got her own Instagram page called Journey to Fairways. So you'll have to check it out. She's got some lovely, lovely pictures on there. Give you a bit of inspo for your home decor, darling.
And the new puppy's on there.
Yes, the new puppy's on there. And she's a, what is she? She's a
little fawn pug.
A what? Pug? Fawn pug. And she's proper cute.
I'm in Hayley's bad book.
Why?
Because she had a dream the other night that I'd got her a puppy, and then when she woke up and didn't have a puppy, I was in trouble.
Oh, no.
Right, let's give them a buff now. Smooth them out. Let's give them a dust with a Nail Nails dusting brush. Right, so I'm going to wipe over these with gel residue wipe off solution now, just to clean up any tiny particles of dust that may be there. So I'm going to get a little bit of Snow White. Right, so what I'm going to do is take a 01 brush and a little bit of this white gel polish, and we're just going to do some like little vines coming through the marbled nail. It's just going to make it pop a little bit. You're kind of working with the marble that's already there. You're just kind of enhancing it. Right, so what we're going to do now on these two is we're going to use the foil glue. And you're going to and I'm not going to use anything special, just the foil glue and the brush from the bottle. And I'm going to just kind of make a really basic leaf shape. Yeah. And we'll do the same on this one. The reason I'm using the brushes because out of the bottle I don't want it to be super perfect. Then we're going to use, out of this pack, we're going to use this one and this one. So we're going to take this one, pop that on, give it a rub onto the foil glue gel. So we're putting the silver side down. We get that little leaf shape. And I'm going to take the other colour on this one. Get a little shape. And then I'm going to use the tweezers. So we've got these little tweezers here, and I'm just going to use the very tip of the tweezer, and I'm going to use this to pull through the middle to create a little vine or vein, and then we're going to create those little veins that a leaf has, coming from the center. Look at that. How easy is that? Same on this one. So what you're kind of doing is scratching away the foil to create those little veins. And then we're going to do it again on this one because I like to layer it. We're going to create one here. So same again, but we're going to slightly overlap onto the other one. Pop me that in the lamp. Right, so we're going to use the slightly different shade. And then we're going to do the same again. So we're going to score through, and we're going to go from the center to create those little veins. And then what I like to do is we're just going to edge with a little bit of the Snow White gel polish. Not on both sides, just coming down here, come down the side, and then I just want to tickle a little bit into those little grooves that we've done. And we're going to do the same on this side, so we're kind of highlighting that side. Then into those little vines. Pop me that into the lamp, and then this one, I'm going to come across this edge and follow the shape. Pop that into the lamp. So I'm going to put the stones on a little bit different this time. I'm going to use some brush on glue, and I'm going to show you how I do it with the top coat as well to secure it all on. So we're going to use crystals, and we're going to use micro beads. Wow, I've got a little bit of the glue here on my thumb, and I can dip into that, and I can add a little bit more, and then I can pick up the little beads, place them on, and you allow that to dry. So we're going to do all of the nails, put our stones on. If you find that your glue is drying too quick, then you can kind of reactivate it with more glue. Right, then we're going to use the top coat now. We're not going to go over the stones. We're going to go up to the stones. And you kind of like tickle it right to the edge of the stone. And it just creeps up to the side of the stone and kind of shrink wraps it onto the nail. Now, if you're using really large stones, I would definitely use the Acrygel to put them on. But because these are quite small, this is just an easier way. It's a little bit quicker than using the Acrygel, but if you're using a large stone, definitely use the Acrygel method. If you don't know what that method is, we will link it below, Adam. Is that okay?
Absolutely. Or if you fear cement.
Or if what?
She has that many stones, she needs cement.
Yeah. Pop me them in the lamp. Right, so I'm going to use the Vitamin E Blueberry Cuticle Oil on Charlotte's much needed skin. But how long does it take for your skin to feel better? You know, like when you haven't got nails on, you bite them. But when you've got nails on, you don't bite them. You don't bite the skin, you don't bite nothing. What is it like? A week, or what do you say?
Yeah, I wouldn't even say a week, to be fair.
Mm.
5 days.
And then you just look amazing.
Yeah.
Your skin looks even better.
Not so dry, not frosty or anything. It's weird because when I've got nails on, I don't want peck or chew or anything. And as soon as they come off, that's it. I can't stop chewing them.
I'm exactly the same. I am exactly the same.
I love just growing nails and just put a bit of polish on them, but it just doesn't happen. As soon as I see a bit of nail, I'm like, oh yes, I can chew that off.
Cute! And that's oil thing is up for you as well. And everybody can look at the full set. Wow.
Beautiful.
And you go like that, turn your hands over and go like that. And then back again. Ooh. Fancy.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today will be listed below in the description box. If you're not subscribed to this channel, please subscribe and give us a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Hi everybody. We're going to do some ASMR. What's it called, ASMR?
But are you whispering?